Why is the question?
Why you don't like Shia?
Would you tell Kia what? Speak
why
English.
You don't like Shia?
I don't what?
I don't like Shia.
Yeah, I don't. Firstly, I don't like anyone.
I check you on Instagram.
Yeah, my Instagram.
You write Shia. Why?
Yeah.
Why you write?
So what's the problem? I tell you why. You want to know why? Because they curse Ummuna Aisha. What do you think of someone curse Ummuna Aisha? Look, don't run. You hear? What do you think of someone curse Ummuna Aisha? What do you think about someone cursing Ummuna Aisha?
Isn't there a hadith saying that
Muawiyah
is like
excuse me, I'm asking him, not you.
No?
I'm asking you. What do you think someone cursing Ummuna Aisha?
Okay, leave it.
Huh?
Leave it.
Look, running. Look, I'm like chicken. Run like chicken. Run like chicken. Jazakallah. Subhanallah. You know, I thought it was sincere because some Shia come to me. Say, Shamsi, why you don't like Shia? When I explain to them, I say, listen, it's not about you like them or don't like them. You know? The point here is, anyone curse my mother Aisha, I don't like him. Simple as that. You understand? That's my teaching. But if she said, listen, I'm not using taqiyya. So I said, no problem, we talk. Do you understand? Look, the wife of the Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You understand, ikhwah? So my dear brothers and my sisters, may I bless you, all those watching. Learn your deen, alhamdulillah, and be aware of the munafiqoon. Prophet Muhammad والسلام, said, يأتي زمان ترى الرجل على أريكته. You see a man on his couch. إذا أتيته بالسنة قل لك لا يكفينا القرآن أو كما قال. He said, if you bring him a sunnah, he will say, no, Quran is enough for me. That's him. That's him. Look, he's angry. You are angry. Rasul spoke about you.
And he spoke about you.
What did he say?
Quran.
Okay, so that's contradiction. So that's contradiction.
Listen.
You want to talk respectfully.
Yeah.
Okay, come here. Okay, respectfully. All right.
Respectfully.
Okay, ask your question. No problem. Okay. Okay. The Quran.
Alhamdulillah.
Who gave it to you?
Who gave it to me? It came from God. Alhamdulillah. It's available on earth for us.
Brother.
Yeah.
Quran, Allah never gave you the Quran that we have directly to you, did
no,
he?
Everything is from Quran, from God.
Now, I didn't ask you that. How did you get the Quran? How did you get?
By the blessings of God, I'm answering you.
Baba, between you, through whom? Through whom?
وَلَا تَجْعَلُوا لِلَّهِ أَنْدَادًا However, the method that came to me at the end of the day
no, through
is
whom?
God.
Through whom? Through whom?
The mailman from Amazon.
That's why. No, forget that. That's why. My point. My brothers. Let me ask you, my brothers.
So you want to ask her?
Yeah, no. My brother. Yeah, it's a joke. Leave him. My brothers. Let me ask you. How do you get the Quran? Through whom?
Through
Sahaba. Khalas. Everyone. Yeah, leave him. Bye. You know why? I'm proving my point. Some people say, Shamsi, don't get frustrated. Do you know why I get frustrated? My brother, if I ask you, what is your name? مَا هُوَ إِسْمُكَ Don't tell me my father drives Mercedes. That's not your name. That's why I got frustrated. Simply, any Muslim, موحد, يتبع الرسول الكريم, العظيم, إلا الكفر الفجر, يقول لك القرآن, أتى من طريق الصحابة الكرام. إلا الكافر الذي صنعته بريطانيا. Except the man who was made by British environment, government when they invaded إنديا بارك الله فيك خلاص الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول يا أيها الذين آمنوا أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول الله أكبر هذا الكافر لا يطيع الرسول ولا يطيع الله لأن الله شوف ما يشوفك لا تعاصمي لا تعاصمي نعم مستكبع الكفر مثلك وهذا هو التكبر نعم القرآن أتاليو الله سيدنا القرآن يا أيها النبي جاهد الكفار والمنافقين واغلظ عليهم الله أكبر القرآن الله واغلظ عليهم
واغلظ عليهم
قالوا
باي تتنزل عليهم الملائكة
تتنزلوا
الملائكة
نعم حتى القرآن
الحمد لله فاطر السماوات والأرض
شوف شيخ خالد
شكرا
حبيبي باي رسول الملائكة الملائكة الرسول اسمع يا بريطانيا انت مع بريطانيا صنعتهم بريطانيا القرآنيون صنعوا ببريطانيا عندما استعمرت الهند صنعوا الأحمديين وصنعوا القرآنيين you know who made this Quranic movement It was the British government when they invaded India. They created two sects, Qadianis and Qur'aniyun, to destroy Islam from within. Historically, the British government did it.
They made
Qur'anis, the movement, and they made Qadianis. Yeah. This movement, I have no mercy on them. If someone is sincere, I can speak to him. But they are, you know, there's research that says when people leave Islam, وَلَيَّذُ بِاللَّهِ, they always, the first step before leaving Islam, they become so-called Qur'aniyun. That is known.
So that guy doesn't believe in
Hadith? At all. He believed Prophet Muhammad was a postman. He comes, give you a book, bye-bye. You do whatever you like. Wallahi.
Allahu Akbar, Shams.
Hayyallah, Habibi, Zon. Hayyakallah. Hayyakallah. Barakallah fi. That's why, you know, Allah يقول, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَا تُجَادِلُ أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا بِالَّتِي أَحْسَنُ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْهُمْ هذا من الذين ظلموا لا يريد الحق فنعامله هكذا إذا أراد الحق أتكلم معه سؤال واضح كيف جاء القرآن إلينا الله لا يعطيك القرآن على طول حتى الرسول لم يكلمنا بين وبين الرسول أكثر من 1000 سنة الإنسان العاقل يقول لك عن طريق الصحابة والتابعين إلا هذا simple question ask him any Muslim you ask my brother how did we get the Quran through whom tell you my brother through the companions تابعين simple I ask the question is on answer and he wants to be like clown here joking around to me go away man go to the circus or something ها لابد واغلظ عليهم بارك الله فيكم you know son شمس اليوم لا شمس ضربتني في الراس يا اخي بعدين خذ رقمي احسن
what's your number
999 Emergency call, call them. Hello, emergency. Push MC through.
You wait there.
Out.
Yeah, wait to him. No problem. Because a lot of people ask this question. Maybe you can.
أخي من هذا؟ Where you from? Where you from?
Holland.
تتكلم عربي؟
أكن هذا العربي.
أي خلي تصل بالعلماء يا أخي اسألهم.
أنت عالم.
لا ليس بعالم أخي. أنا والله ماني بعالم أصلاً.
Maybe you know.
لا أنا بتصل بالعلماء أخي. والله أحسن إذا تتكلم عربي تصل بالعلماء. اتصل في مشايخ في الجزائر اعطيك شيخ عبد الاله الحمامي ما ادري رقمه نسيت انا لكن هو في تطوان يا هو عنده رقمي قل له يتصل بي وانا اعطي احد رقم العلماء والمشايخ ويتصل بهم احسن احسن لان الاصل ندب الى العلماء ندب الى شمسي العلماء هو الاصل نرجع اليهم الله يقول فاسالوا اهل الذكر ان كنتم لا تعلمون والنبي يقول العلماء ورثه الانبياء بارك الله فيك فهمت حبيبي احسن والله يا اخي Ikhwah, by the way, my dear brothers, Allah bless you all, we are doing a campaign to raise the money for our masjid. Because our masjid, subhanAllah, is behind a market in the alleyway. Tayyib. And subhanAllah, if you want to see the videos, you can go back to our channel, Das Da'wah. فبالعربي كذلك, خلو انجليزي عربي, نحن بتوفيق الله نجمع تبرعات لمسجدنا, دار السنة, لأن subhanAllah, المسجد في مكان من وراء جنب السوق, وسبحانAllah, علينا كما أقول لك, صاحب المحل عفوا صاحب المكان وهو المسجد هذا خبيث يضيق علينا في الساعات والاشياء والمكان صغير جدا وفي المزبله سبحان الله في الخارج فنحن نجمع المال لنشتري مسجدا جديدا ان شاء الله تعالى بارك الله فيكم والاخوه يضعون لديتوز بارك الله فيكم وين التايم برو؟ سبحان الله. I've already lost my voice, you know. تعرف عندي يعني.
حياتي ليك شيخ شمسي.
الله يحييك حبيبي. الله يعزك كيف الحال؟ بخير طيب. الحمد لله السلام عليكم. كيف الحال اخوي؟ لاباس كيف
الحمد لله بارك الله فيك.
ما شاء الله.
الله يحفظك.
مين اخ ليبيا؟
ليبيا
ما شاء الله. حيا الله اخوانا من ليبيا. ليبيا تتلك. ما شاء الله من ليبيا؟ مطابلس ما شاء الله ما شاء الله انا عندي صاحبي وحبيبي من ليبيا اسمه عبد الرحمن ادعوا له ربي يسهل الامور
ان شاء الله ربي
والله يا اخ ما شاء الله بارك الله فيكم حبيبي حياكم الله
جزاكم
الله خير بارك الله فيكم وإياكم اخي يا عندنا اخ والله الاخ عزيز علينا من ليبيا هو ما شاء الله يمر بي سبحان الله يمر بمشاكل ما تنسوا اخاكم عبد الرحمن بالدعاء والله وادعوا لكل المسلمين ان شاء الله